ऑडियंस एंगेजमेंट इट्स वन ऑफ द मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट थिंग फॉर अस टू ग्रो अवर यूट्यूब चैनल बी इट गेटिंग मोर व्यूज और सब्सक्राइबर्स और इवन अर्निंग्स करेक्ट सो इन दिस वीडियो आई एम गोइंग टू शेयर हाउ द कमेंट फीचर दैट इज देयर इन यूट्यूब वी कुड टेक हेल्प ऑफ इट एंड हैव बेटर ऑडियंस एंगेजमेंट आई एम श्योर यू माइट बी यूजिंग द कमेंट सेक्शन बट देर आर गुड अमाउंट ऑफ फीचर्स दैट आर देयर Probably you may be knowing or you may not be knowing. So I'm going to explain each and everything in detail. So watch till the end because it's something amazing that I'm going to share which helps in great audience engagement. And that's what is required to grow the channel. Okay. So let's quickly dive into our YouTube channel. Okay. So I have just connected to one of my YouTube channel, A2Z Construction. So this is my another channel. Now I'll quickly tell the features that are there. At the comment section. So this is my video. Now if I just come below and see the comments, there are 52 comments which it is showing. You have the option to sort by as well. Okay, so I'll not go there right now. Now here is something. Okay, so really good stuff. Can you tell how much is the distance you have kept from the floor to TV? Okay, so I just replied to that. Make sure you always reply to the comments, correct? Why? Because say for example, okay, you have 100 comments, okay, which you have received for a video. And if you comment for all of the 100 comments, then you are going to have 200 comments on that video. That means for YouTube algorithm, what it sees is as 200 comments, correct? That means it's better audience engagement. So make sure you take some time and respond to all your, all the people who have commented on your video. That way, it also gives a good feeling for the people who are commenting because you value their comments as well. Okay, so that's something that you could do. So make sure first you give a comment to them. Now, say for example, okay, you really love the comment what they have sent across. Okay, certainly you can like, and there is another feature called as love. You can certainly give a love to that. Now, love or heart symbol, whatever you want to say. Now, when you give this, the beauty of that is, it actually goes as a notification to the person who has commented, correct? Now that's a fantastic thing because the person will come to know that, okay, you have given a heart for their comment. Then they would be more than happy to comment on your upcoming videos as well, correct? So make sure to use this heart comment that is a heart feature that is there so that you give them the hearts for all the comments that you like. There is no limit. You can certainly give hearts to as many comments as possible as well. Okay, say for example, okay, and I like something else as well. Sir, what's the cost estimate for this interior? So I'll say, okay, I'll give a love symbol for this as well, correct? So good job, I'll just give a heart symbol to this as well. So one of the person is asking, please explain about video, what you are going to do. This simple music is waste. So if somebody is giving a constructive feedback, take it positively and respond to them so that you value their comments as well. So I would say in my latest video, I have given the voice instruction as well. Thanks for your suggestion. Now, so this will probably make them feel good that, okay, you have really considered their comment and you have been applying that, correct? So that's a very constructive feedback, and please do make sure you respond to them in the positive way so that you get better audience engagement as well, correct? So that's the first thing that I said is about using the heart symbol or love symbol, whatever you want to call, okay, and giving hearts to the comments that you really like them. Okay, now the second most important feature that I want to say here is, now if you just click here, okay, there is an option called as pin. Now let me tell you what actually pin does. Okay, so when you actually pin a particular comment, it actually comes to the top. Now say for example, okay, I want to pin a comment in this video. Say for example, okay, I'll just go down. See here, somebody is asking give complete house tour. Now, say for example, I want to pin this at the top. So I'll just pin it, okay? Now it will say, if you already pinned a comment, this will replace it. So I'll just say, okay, pin it. Now the beauty is that actually comes to the top, correct? Now, say for example, okay, there are some negative comments and other things on the video. So when you pin a particular good comment, it actually stays on the top and people are going to see what you actually want them to see first. So that's one of the best way for you to pin. And one other great feature that I would say is where you could use the pin is, say for example, okay, let me know what is the next video you want to see in this channel. Okay, so I'll put this, okay, and what I'll do is I can certainly pin this as well. I can certainly pin this as well, correct? So that means you can actually pin a question, or you can pin a fantastic comment, or certainly you can ask a question, okay? Or say for example, in the video there is some miscommunication that is there, and if you want the viewers to know that, then certainly you can write in the comment and pin it so that it's always on the top. You can certainly do that, correct? So that's a pin feature that is there. Now the next feature that I would say is there is an option called as remove. That means, say for example, okay, you are getting a nasty comment or the comment which is not really good. In that case, you have all the option to remove that comment. So go ahead and remove it as well if you really feel that, okay, it's not a good comment to stay there. Okay, now second or third most important thing is report. Now say for example, okay, there is a person who is not using good language and he's actually abusing, or he's always trying to spam or things like that, then certainly you can report. Just click on the report. Okay, once you click on report, you have something like unwanted commercial content or spam, pornography or sexually explicit material, child abuse, hate speech or graphic harassment or bullying. Now why you should be doing that is because, see, the person who would be doing on your channel could also be doing on the other channels as well. So if you think that, okay, there is a person who is not doing it right, then go ahead and report it so that YouTube will take the right steps, and probably the user would also be removed from YouTube as well. Okay, so make sure you use that as well. And the last one that I want to say here is hide user from channel. Now say for example, okay, you have a user where you don't want to remove or report or things like that, and probably the comments, whatever they are giving, is not something appealing for you, and you really don't want to see that comment on your channel, okay, and you don't want others to see as well. In that case, select that comment and hide user from channel. That means whatever comments that they are going to make in future, it's never going to appear on the channel, okay? So it will be listed in the review section, so that if you really wanted to go and approve it, you can do it, or you can just leave it like that, so that then a comment from that person is never going to come. And the other beauty is the person is not going to know that, okay, you are actually hiding his comments, okay? So that's the beauty of it. Now we'll move to the next section. Now say for example, okay, you are getting a lot of comments and you are not able to manage them easily. In that case, you can just click on your channel icon, okay, go to YouTube Studio. Once you go there, you have something called as comment section here, okay? So just click on the comment section. Okay, now if you see here, you see all the comments that are there. You see all the comments, okay? Now the beauty is they also have filters here. Now the first thing that you see is published comments. That means these are the comments which are actually active on the videos where people can actually see them. Held for review, okay? So these are probably the comments which are held for review, so that I can go ahead and approve. Now see here. So the person is actually trying to promote their website, okay? So same here. So in that case, here is somebody who is asking for sub for sub, okay, and somebody sharing their cell phone number, correct? So in that case, YouTube will be holding it for review based on the settings that I have made. Next, YouTube also has an option to trigger it as a spam if they are doing the same activity on multiple channels. Now say for example, okay, super video, we want the next video soon, okay? Now this is actually a valid comment, okay? so I'll just approve this. And he said like that, I'll just approve this. This is, so this is something where he's trying to promote his channel, which is still a spam. Okay, spam. Okay, so successful, sir. Okay, so I'll just approve this as well. Correct. Again, spam. So in that way, you can see the comments which are listed in spam as well. Okay. Now I'll go to published comments. Okay. So I'll just close this. Now, if you click on filter, you have multiple options. Okay. It says search. You can search by a keyword. Say, for example, okay. It contains a question. Let me know what is the next video you want to see. Oh, that's the question that I posted. I love the building and how can I contact you? Correct. He's asking you a question. So it actually lists all the questions that are there so that you can take time and respond. Okay. So that's a great way. And one other beauty of questions is you actually come to know what your audience are actually looking for. Say, for example, okay. So somebody is asking, what's the music? So which material is used in drawers at 54-52 seconds of video? In that way, it actually gives me what is the other videos that I also can create. Correct. So I can create a video on what kind of drawers are made and what is the material that is used. Correct. So in that way, you will get a lot more idea about this is about content question. Now, in a similar way, it has public subscribers. Okay. So this is something that is option is there where you could see. Okay. So I'll just close this, then moving on to the next one. It has channel membership status. Now, channel membership status is, say for example, if you have membership for your channel, okay, in that case, it would show comments from channel members only. Okay, so that's the what it is there. Subscriber count. The beauty is you can also see if there are people, based on the number of subscribers, you can see if people are commenting on that. Say for example, okay, I want to search. If there is anyone who is commenting who has more than 100,000 subscribers, so let me just see that. See the beauty. So I see subscriber count is greater than 100,000, but okay, so that's what it is saying, but I really don't know if it is valid because it says 6 subscribers here and here it says 32 subscribers. Okay, so let me just go to this channel and see. So it doesn't have so much. I don't know if this is really valid or not. Let me just search once again. So if you have used this feature, subscribers count, and if you know what is that, then just let me also know. Okay, so it doesn't apply, I think. So let me just remove this and quickly I'll show you the other feature that is there. Response status. This is one of the most important things. Say for example, okay, you have 100 comments, okay, and you want to filter only those for which you have not responded. In that case, you can select I haven't responded. Okay, now it becomes easy for you to just reply to this. Okay, he said nicely explained, thank you. I can just glad it was helpful. Okay, I'll just reply that and leave it. Okay, reply. Correct. So this is your house. So I'll say yes. Correct. So that's how you can use the feature of you can use more features that are there in the comment section for better managing the comments. Now let's move on to the third part. Okay, where you can actually set the defaults. So let me just once you go to YouTube Studio. Okay. Click on settings. Okay, once you click on settings, you have something called as community tab. Now here, if you have a bandwidth where like you want to put somebody for moderating for the comments, you can certainly put that channel user here, approved users to view the comment. Now you can see these are the users that I had blocked. Correct. Initially I said that, okay, how you can hide users. So these are the users that I have hidden because they were putting nasty comments. Correct. Now blocked words. So you can actually write the words that people should not be commenting on your channel, okay? It could be awful words or bad words, whatever it is. You can certainly type it here and click on save. And the next most important thing that is there is defaults. Here, so you have something, allow all comments. That means whatever people are going to come comment, it will be directly public on your video, okay? Or hold potentially inappropriate comments for review. That means make sure you select this option. It is good because YouTube will hold inappropriate comments for review, as I told earlier in the previous thing, okay, where there are spams and there are few comments held for review, okay? Or hold all comments for review. That means you want to review each and every comment or disable comments. I say that do not disable the comments because it's very much necessary for you to have that audience engagement. So I would recommend having hold potentially inappropriate comments for review. So that's what I would say. So this is the information that I wanted to share. I hope it's going to help you to have better audience engagement and to get better views and subscribers as well. Okay. So thank you very much. If you are not already subscribed to this channel, then please do subscribe for more wonderful videos which would be coming in the future. Thank you. Have a great day.